This is a magnetic pendulum. It's an extremely simple device, just an iron ball positioned above three magnets arranged in a triangle. However, when the bob is released, it follows a seemingly random path around the magnets, almost seeming to orbit them, becoming entangled with them in no discernible fashion, until suddenly it comes to a halt above just one of the magnets. Let's do an experiment. When the bob is released from one place, it moves in a random manner, as before, and ends up stopped above one magnet. However, when the bob is released from a slightly different place, almost exactly the same as the last run, it follows a completely different path and gets pulled in by a different magnet. It's clear that there's something peculiar happening here. To understand this better, computer simulation might be useful. This next section of the video will succinctly demonstrate how such a computer model might work. This rather complicated looking equation is the Newtonian equation of motion describing how the bob, or the swinging part, of the pendulum moves. Put simply, this equation describes the total force acting on the pendulum bob, which is the same as mass times acceleration as per Newton's second law. Some simplifications have been made here to make these equations easier to understand and use. The first part of this equation describes force from the magnets. By Coulomb's law, the force acting upon two point magnetic charges is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Here, it's assumed they're equal for brevity's sake. The sum of the forces over all magnets is taken, and the H constant represents how high the bob is above the magnets. The second part of this equation describes the restoring force on the bob to its position at rest, which is equal to the negative of some constant K times the displacement as per Hooke's law for oscillators. The third and final part of the equation describes damping, which is described by the mu coefficient times the velocity of the bob. This force represents gravity, air resistance, and the like. All in all, the system is described by this equation, which despite appearing complex, is actually relatively easy to program into a computer and solve numerically. Despite this model's simplicity, it exhibits much of the same behavior as the physical pendulum. When a single pendulum is released in the simulation, it orbits the magnets in much the same fashion as before. And when a few pendulums are released a minuscule distance apart, we display the same unpredictable motion seen in the physical version. Another way to understand the dynamics at play is by coloring each point by which magnet it lands on. Each magnet is given a different color. Then, from each point on the screen, the pendulum simulation is run for a certain amount of time. The original point is then given the color of the magnet the bob is closest to, oftentimes the one it lands on. The picture is initially quite low fidelity, but as the resolution is increased, a detailed and chaotic image emerges. It seems that the magnetic pendulum's strange properties have carried over here as well. This is chaos, in its purest form. Why does chaos emerge here? Many forces are acting on the bob, which leads to solutions appearing random and unpredictable in the long term. In fact, no analytical solution exists, i.e., it's impossible to express a solution in terms of existing mathematical functions. The system displays a remarkable sensitivity to initial conditions, as we have seen, which is one of the bellwethers of chaos. When the image is examined closer, other signs of chaos appear. For one, the image we just produced displays the peculiar property that the boundary of one colored region is always also the boundary of the other two. Let's remove the yellow and navy regions. The red region, called the red magnet's basin of attraction, that's left behind, seems to permeate every other, interlacing with the other colors. It seems that the basins of attraction in this fractal twist and mingle with each other in intricate patterns on and on down to infinity. And from this, one can see that chaos is more common than most people might think. Chaos isn't just out of our reach in grand and complicated math. Even a modification to the simple pendulum can demonstrate it. I think I'll finish this video off by playing some video clips of these magnetic pendulum fractals evolving with time. Thanks for watching this short film.